Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, everyone. Hello, my name is Nadif Adlan. I'm from Muhammadiyah University of Yogyakarta. In this occasion, we will talk about five greatest Muslim thinkers. But first of all, I'm very thank you of you because you've watched my video. And before of that, I hope you can be very proud as a Muslim because actually, in history, we have tons, we have a lot of great Muslim thinkers. But in this occasion, we just will talk about five greatest Muslim thinkers. First, we will talk about Imam Mawardi. So I hope you have heard his name. He is a scholar of Shafi'i's madhab, and he lived in Abbasid era. So we can conclude that if he lived in Abbasid era, so he lived in Islamic golden age era. He is a political thinker also, and he's a very phenomenal thinking about politics is about modern governance. So it's very amazing, guys. He lived in Middle Age era, but his thinking is about modern governance. So it's very amazing thinking, I think. And if you are interested with his thinking, with his masterpiece, you can read his book named Al-Ahkam As-Sultaniyah. His book is about, it's about government and about political thinking. His book has been translated in Indonesia also. And the next is Ibn Khaldun. He is very famous, and I hope you ever hear his name also. His thinking is about, his political thinking is about power organism. So what does it mean? Power organism means that the power is like a living being. So the power maybe is like a human because power can born, can grow, can develop, and can die. If you are curious from where he can get that thinking, actually he can think about his political thinking is because his long experience and his involvement in the political dynasties. And if you're interested with his masterpiece, with his book, you can read Muqaddimah. Muqaddimah is the book of Ibn Khaldun and has been translated also in Indonesia. Next, I hope you know him because he is very famous in Islamic madhab. He is Imam Ahmad. Imam Ahmad also lived in Abbasid era, but he lived in early Abbasid era. He is a critical thinker, even to his teacher. His teacher named Imam Ash-Shafi'i, also the founder of Shafi'i's madhab. But he is a critical thinker even to his teacher. So he's very great. His masterpiece is Kitab al-Musnad. Kitab al-Musnad contains, I think, thousands of hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So it's very good for you if you want to, want to study hadith, want to study Islamic law, maybe. Next, he's very famous thinker in Islam named Ibn Sina. He lived in Abbasid era, and also he lived in Islamic golden age era. He is a multidiscipline scholar, multidiscipline learner, because he is a political and medical thinker. His very famous political thinking is about leader must come from intellectual. Why? Because the intellectual can increase the morality of the country or of the dynasty. And if the morality of the dynasty or the country has been increased, can be increased, so the productivity can be increased also. So it makes sense. And his medical thinking is about modern medical management. So it's very good. He lived in Islamic golden age era, in Middle Age, but he can think about modern medical management. So he is very incredible thinker. If you are interested with his medical book, you can read about canon of medicine, Al-Qanun Fitib. His book also has been translated to a lot of language, including English, but I don't know in Indonesia. And maybe you can search that. The last but not least, he is Imam Al-Ghazali. He is very famous in Islamic tasawuf, I think. He lived in Abbasid era also, but he lived in the in last Abbasid era. He did practice of debates against the Shia people because he is a scholar from Sunni people. Also, he is a critical thinker, and his very famous critical thinking is about his thinking of managing philosophy thought. So he made his book named Tahafut al-Falasifa contains his thinking about philosophy. Okay, that's all from me, I think. I hope you can be motivated as a Muslim for being a great thinker, and I hope my explanation is useful for you. Thank you so much. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.